I think Lewis Carroll was very keen to make sure that everyone understood that Alice was kind of part of this new generation of women who were very different to their predecessors.
Yeah.
And weren't prepared to stand for the status quo for much longer. And that happened. Alice's generation is a generation that grew up to be suffragettes. So they changed the world in many ways. And I think Alice was part of that generation, so that's very important to me. Mum says it best. Her mum says in the film, Alice can do whatever Alice chooses to do. And that for women of that time, that's very unusual, because in Victorian England, you had to do what you were told, pretty much, if you were a girl. And that, I think, is what Alice teaches her mum in this movie. So it's a really nice message, and I think that's very important today, too.
Or sadly, there are some people today still trying to tell girls they have to do what they're
told. Exactly.
So we're still pushing back on that.
No, I know.
Right?
Yeah. Not one yet.
Right.
If you could choose three people, dead or alive, to invite to a Mad Hatter's tea party, who would be there and why?
Well, if they're dead, it'd be no fun, would it? I mean,
time travel, you could bring them back first, then, yeah.
English speaking or non-English speaking, because that's also a big thing.
I don't know.
I don't know. Three's hard. I don't know. Oscar Wilde.
Yeah.
He's got a good one. Charles Dickens.
Yeah.
Also very good.
It's quite a highbrow chat.
Yeah, I know, it's a very highbrow chat. You can get someone slightly more low. And Charlie Chaplin.
Nice!
There you go. I remember going to see Tim in Vancouver to talk about making the movie, and he gave me a warning saying how hard it was. And did I listen? No, I'm still here today. But his amazing advice initially was don't shoot on green because it sends you completely crazy. So I didn't do that. I shot on blue. That was incredibly helpful. and then from that day onwards, he created such a beautiful world in the first movie. I felt very much we had to create this one within the parameters of that world. So, you know, in terms of like character design and location design, it was very helpful. And then, of course, script stuff. And then actually, obviously, Tim lives in London. So he shot here in London too, which was very helpful. So he was around for that. So no, it was incredibly helpful for me because it's like, you know, it's his world. So I was just very pleased to be able to draw on his experience of it.
But really important as well for you to make it your world as well.
Yeah, no, for sure, no, because obviously I felt that this film is set in a different time period and it's set in different geographical locations. There's a certain different feel I could bring to it to a degree, but I felt it had to stay within the same universe, you know, in terms of, because the characters pre-existed and I felt that, Sasha's character had to very much fit in the kind of, you know, paint box of those people. Mm. And so that's why we went with a sort of, I always think about silhouettes in character design. His silhouette is very striking, gigantic shoulder pads, you know, and it's like, for me, it's like he designed it because he's a show-off. And so therefore he wanted to impress people.
My character.
So his character, not so. No, so it just felt like he very much fitted into that world, you know, so that was quite a good.
Do you both believe that there's an accurate and fair representation of LGBT characters in Disney movies today to teach the next generation about the ever-changing world that we all live in?
That's a jolly good question. I think so. I mean, it's hard. I think something everyone's very aware of these days, and whenever you make anything, it's something you always, because it's part of the world you live in. And I think when you make a film these days, you can't help but put that into it anyway. And so, you know, people always say to me, how do you update Lewis Carroll? You say, I just do what I think is interesting and important. I think so. It's one of the things that I think people are always very aware of, I think, I'm pretty sure.